What's up, y'all? It's Misha. Okay, back at y'all with another video. And today, tonight, whatever you want to call it, whatever the case may be, if you can already tell by the title, I don't know how to help you. I said what I said, like I said. If you're new here, hey, what's up? Check out the channel. If you like it, go ahead and subscribe. If you're not new here, hey, girl, hey, boy, what's up? It's drama, and who don't like drama? Everybody like drama, so I'm gonna tell the story about the drama. Yeah. So, I ain't gonna do too much. I'm gonna just tell the story. I don't know what I'm gonna title it as. So, I'm gonna just get to it. Keep me on track for the video. I got my notebook, my handy dandy notebook. Got my name on it right here. All the people right here. We're gonna start off with the girl. I'm gonna call her Delusional. We're gonna start off with her dude. His name gonna be Mr. Delusion. And we gonna call her sister Sadie. And mind you, Sadie and Delusional, the two sisters, they both have their own kids. Delusional has one child, he's a boy, and Sadie has a baby girl. Mr. Delusion got kids too, but their kids really don't come into play like that for real. Make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe, and let's go ahead and get to the video. Okay, y'all, so before I actually tell y'all why me and Delusional was about to square up, I gotta tell y'all who she is and how I met her. My bad. I met Delusional in October. Recently, I met Delusional in October at this event that Mr. Delusion was holding. He asked me, could I come? And I came with two of my friends. I'm not gonna say who my friends are, it's just two of my friends. The reason why she came about is because one of my friends already met her some type of way. I don't know how, I never really asked her how she met her, but that's how she knew her. And when she came to the little event that he was hosting, she came to our table because she knew my friend already. I didn't know her. And apparently her and Mr. Delusion was dating. Yeah, that's how I met her. So, yeah, we at this event, y'all. My jaw is dead as fuck. The event was dead as hell. I thought it was gonna be pumping and jumping because apparently he supposed to be that nigga. Sorry, y'all. He supposed to be that ninja. I can't say the N-word. He supposed to be that ninja. But, y'all, the movie was dead, y'all. When I tell y'all that movie, the party was dead, y'all. When I tell y'all the party was dead. There was nobody in there. It was small as hell. Good thing they got a small space, because if it was a big space, it would have been real embarrassing. But they were playing music, but wasn't nobody dancing. They had no chairs. They had tables to stand up at. You had to pay for the drinks. You had to pay to get in. All that money for nobody to be up in there. She moved here, her and her sister and their kids, they moved down here the same month, so October, when I met her. That's when she met Mr. Delusion, so it's not like she knew him for years. She is not from here, she's not from Florida. I knew Mr. Delusion from school, not gonna say what school, but I knew him from school, so I been knew who he was. I ain't gonna lie, she was a cool girl. We was conversating. Me and her was chatting it up. She really wasn't talking to my friends like that, even though she knew one of them already. But me and her was cool. We kind of kicked it off. We bonded on the fact that we both had kids and they were boys. We both bonded on the fact that we had YouTube channels. The age difference is that I'm just 4 years older than her and I'm 24. So, yeah. But other than that, she seemed like a cool girl. She was funny. She was just good vibes. Like, honestly, she was just good vibes, y'all. So the situation about her and Mr. Delusion, honestly, from what I've seen since the short period of time that I was cool with her and hanging around her, because I hung around her a lot after that, kind of frequently after that, honestly, she would do anything for Mr. Delusion. Like, it's nothing that I doubt that she wouldn't do anything for Mr. Delusion. Like, this girl was a yes girl. Like, everything he said, she did. Like, they're not dating. They're just having sex with each other. It was clear that they both was messing with other people, but apparently they didn't care. So I told her, like, why'd you let him, you know, if you really like him and you really want a relationship with him, why are you being with him knowing that he don't want more than that? Because he always told me he ain't looking for nothing else, he just looking for fun. Her thing that she loved to say, which I don't know why y'all girls be saying this, because it's not cute. That's high school stuff. But she said, oh, she don't care as long as he know where home at. That ain't none of my business. I don't, none of my business, okay? But mind you, like I said before, y'all, her and her sister had just moved here. Her mom is not down, was not down here yet. She did not move down here with them. Working at her job until her job transfers back over here. So, yeah, she basically, they basically just came down here and waited for her to come back. Because of that, they've been staying in Airbnbs and hotel rooms since they've been down here since October. And, y'all, it's December right now. So, yeah. And because, you know, since they staying from place to place, you know you gotta pay for all of that. You know they're running out of money. So, one of them had to start working a job. Working a job that chose to work a job to win the money for both of them was Delusional. Around this time, me and Delusional are friends. We pretty much cool for the most part. So, Delusional, she started a new job. And she needed someone to watch her baby. We just gonna call him Junior, okay? We just gonna call Junior. So Delusional wanted me to watch Junior for her while she go to work because her sister Sadie had to take her own baby to a doctor's appointment, right? Which is perfectly understandable. With me being the only person that she knows, that I've been around her since she's been down here. So I was like, fine, whatever. I'll watch Junior or whatever. Junior to my house. Junior the night before, which would be a Sunday. And she also wanted me to hold some of their stuff because I said, yeah, I'll hold y'all stuff, even though I know how my mama is about people that she don't really know, but I kind of convinced her to just hold a little bit. It was a little bit of their stuff. It wasn't no lot of stuff. I did let her know that I was planning on going out of town to celebrate my baby's birthday, which was on the 16th, which would be a Friday. She brought Junior to my house Sunday night, y'all. When she brought Junior to my house, y'all, I was already planning on giving him a bath, but I really had to give him a bath because, girl, when she brought him over, the little boy, he had an explosion in his diaper. And I don't know what for. I don't know how. You know what? I'm not even gonna lie like that. I ain't even gonna lie like that. Because when I used to visit them at their little places, Junior diaper would be sagging. And like you could tell that Junior needed to be changed. And I would ask her, like, he needs to change. Like his, you don't see his diaper, like I'm like, you need to change him because his diaper is falling off. Like his booty crack showing. Like y'all, I kid y'all not, like his booty crack would be showing, his diaper would be sagging. I would be telling her to change him and she would tell me to change. And I wouldn't do it because I'm like, he's not my child, but I don't need to change. Why do I need to change him and he's not my child? That's your child. You need to change him. But I ain't never really said nothing. I just was like, whatever, girl, sis, if you want him to walk around with a saggy diaper and his booty crack hanging out, girl, be my guest. None of it was in the diaper at all. Like, none of it. It all slid down his leg and in his car seat. It was so nasty, y'all. And I was the one that had to clean it up. Because she was not going to clean it up, y'all. It was so nasty. And she just thought it was so funny that I had that mess, a little bit of mess on my shirt. Like, she was like, oh, just go throw him in the bath. Even though I was going to do that anyway. But she was like, just go throw him in the bath. Just wash it off in the tub. Girl, I'm not finna put no boo-boo in my tub. Like, that's nasty. I just washed my tub. What I look like, I'm not finna put no boo-boo in my tub. I'm not doing that. That's dirty. That's stinking dirty. I'm not doing that. So, I was like, where the wipes at? She told me, oh, I forgot his wipes because I felt like I was getting rushed. I wasn't rushing her at all. I was just asking her where she was at because I did not want her to bring the baby so late to my house because, girl, I might be asleep. Like, bring the baby at a certain time. I sent her to the store to go get wipes and to go get the baby some wipes and go get my son some wipes because I needed wipes as well. I sent her like $4 to go get a pack of wipes for me. So I used a wipe. I found like a wipe and paper towel to wipe her son off. I went and threw him in the tub. I washed him off. I lotioned him. I put clothes on him. She gave me the car seat and I told her to clean it out herself. But she's like, no, you clean it out. I don't want to clean it out because it got stuff on. I'm like, girl, of course, it does. You the mother, you gotta clean it. But she was just like, she wanted me to clean it. She wanted me to spray it off with a hose, pour some water on it, let it run out. Like, oh my God, that's so nasty. Like, let me stop. I put some gloves on. I got a garbage bag. I put it on top of the garbage bag. Yeah, I just went in with Clorox wipes, just cleaning it off. I cleaned it all off, and I put it in the washer. I took the clothes, my clothes off, his clothes off, his little teddy bear that he was cuddling it with inside of. I just took everything off and threw that stuff in the washer, and I washed it twice. Like, when I washed it the first time, y'all, I washed it a second time, because I'm not finna have, like, that's nasty. That's so nasty. So that, y'all, she came back, gave me the wipes, and she went about on her merry way. That was Sunday night, because she had to go to work on Monday morning. I mean, we basically had a normal day. I had a normal day with the baby. He was fine. He wasn't no bad baby. I fed him. Meanwhile, y'all, she ain't bring no food for him. She ain't bring no drinks, no snacks, no nothing for him. I basically had to feed the baby out of my house on my own. I had to share my son's snacks. I really feel like I shouldn't have had to, because you knew your baby. You knew you was gonna ask me to watch your baby. But I mean, I had to do it, because I mean, I could not feed the baby, you know, whatever. So when she came and got him, y'all, she basically was telling me that she was convincing me. She said that Mr. Delusion wanted to do a play. He wanted to do a play, y'all know what a play is. And she wanted me to, you know, get in on it, because it'll be free money or whatever. But I just let her convince me. I don't know. Y'all can call me dumb too, because I know I'm dumb. I don't know why I did that. But I let her convince me into giving her my stuff. I feel like I was being too impatient. I just wasn't letting him. I was being very impatient, and I was being greedy. I feel like I was being greedy. And, you know, I'm a hold that accountable to myself. So she said the next day, or that same night, she was gonna see him. She was gonna give him hers and go give him mine. Before she left, I told her, I don't know, you might have to give it back soon, because I might be out of town. And also, I wanted to do yours first, because I'm a scary little girl. Like, I'm scary. I'm very scary. I don't want to be made out of an example out of other stuff, of bad stuff. So I don't want people to get in trouble before I would ever get in trouble, so I can say that I don't want to do it anymore. But honestly, something like that, I did not want to do it. I just kind of let her talk me into it, and I wanted to back out around the last minute, which I feel like you should just let me just back out. Like, let me be a punk. I don't care if I'm a punk. I don't care if I'm lame or all of that. Like, baby, I don't look good in orange, and I don't look good around people. I don't look good around no gel. Y'all, next morning, I call her up. I'm like, girl, just bring me my card, man. I don't want to do it no more. Like, I'm kind of anxious. Like, I don't want to do it no more. I don't know why I gave it to you. No more. Right now, I don't want to do it no more. So she was like, oh, I don't have it no more. Mr. Delusion got the cards. I gave it to him. So I text Mr. Delusion, because like I said, y'all, I knew him before she knew him. And I asked him, did he have the cards? Y'all, he said no. And he was like, he didn't get started on anything yet. I asked him that also. He said no. And I told him, you know what, just have her to give mine back, and you just do hers, and then y'all let me know how it go. And then if I decide to do it with y'all then I'll do it with y'all then. Oh, I gotta give it to my dude. I don't know why I told him this, but I was like, I gotta give it to my dude, because my dude wanna hold it real quick, blah 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 blah. And he was like, oh, why your dude ain't been do something on it? She also said it when I was telling her about it. She's like, why your dude ain't been do something on it? He should have been asked for it. I feel like it don't matter who asked for it first. Like, it's mine. Like, y'all kind of giving me, like, now I feel like y'all trying to hold myself hostage, because now y'all talking about some why they ain't asked for it first before you gave it to us. It don't matter. It's my car. Like, give me my stuff. Like, he gonna text her behind. I'm on the phone with her while I'm doing this. He gonna text her talking about some, oh, do she want the money or not? She like, girl, he said, do you want the money or not? I said, no, I don't want the money. Just give me my stuff back. Because now it seems like y'all being right, like, real fishy. Like, I don't like that. I said, no, just give my stuff back. She's talking about, I'm gonna have to give it to you after I get off work. I'm like, girl, that's perfectly fine. I don't care. 4 o'clock is around the, it's around the corner. I don't care. Just give me my stuff back. I don't care. She was just like, girl, just be patient. You just being real anxious. Don't let your dude bully you into doing stuff. We finna get it. We finna just get it and go and just be patient. You don't gotta stress out. It's da 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 da. Let Mr. Delusional work. In the middle of this all happening, y'all, I'm checking my stuff to see if anything happening on it on my app, right? Mind y'all, I'm still asking for my stuff back. I'm still asking for my car back. And she just keeps saying, oh girl, just calm down, blah, 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 blah. We'll let you know what's going on. I'm texting him, I'm asking him, oh, what's going on? How long is this finna take? How long is y'all finna take? Because I want my stuff back. Girl, he's ignoring me. So y'all, we're gonna call him the middleman. And the middleman is the person that's actually doing the... And I guess Mr. Delusion gave him my number because me and him was texting each other. So yeah, basically he was asking me for information because, or he was telling me about what's going on because he gave him the stuff so that I know whatever. But meanwhile, he telling me, oh, he about to get everything started, y'all. At this point, I felt kind of pressured because I'm like, I told y'all I didn't want to do this no more. And y'all kind of just went against my will. And y'all got my stuff. And y'all gave this man my stuff, knowing that I told both of y'all that I didn't want to do it no more. And yeah, I ain't like that. I didn't like that, y'all. I felt like I was doing it against my will, so I kind of went with it. And I was just communicating with the dude. Let me know if he need me to answer any questions or need any stuff from me, right? Basically, I started changing the password to my stuff, y'all, because I feel like if I told y'all I don't want to do it no more, why is y'all trying to make me do it anyway? My man, y'all, when I tell y'all, my man told me to the flow up, he was yelling at me like, my man be yelling at me like, oh my God, y'all, he was yelling at me. He was so mad at me, y'all. He was so, looking, speaking of that, look at him texting me. So I wanted to act fast to stop this stuff from happening. So what I did, I went in my little app, I kept changing passwords, pretending like I don't know what's happening while the middleman asked me. He's like, hey, this is not working. It's telling me that it's wrong. I don't want to keep doing it because of the locket. And da 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 da. And I was just acting like I didn't know what was happening. Knowing that, well, I know what I'm doing. But I'm just trying to pretend like, I don't know. Maybe I have to call them. I'm trying, like, you know. I honestly feel like I'm, like, in the moment, like, before everything goes left, it's like I be wanting to please everybody. Like, I don't want people to be mad at me. But if I don't want something, I don't want something. And I need to snap out of it. Like, bitch, if I don't want to do it, I don't want to do it. Like, I should have told them from the get-go, if y'all don't give me my stuff back, I will close it. And I need to say that. Like, I didn't say that. I basically made up a plan so that I could stop it. And then, you know, I basically marked it as lost. I said that I was gonna have another card sent to me. And I told the dude, I'm thinking that it's gonna stop everything. It's gonna let go of the hole. It's gonna go back to wherever it came from. But it didn't. It was still going through. I guess he's notifying everybody else about it, Mr. Delusion and Delusional. Because out of everybody, and I didn't know him at all, he was the only one that I felt like I was comfortable with and talking to, because they wasn't giving me no type of answers. Like, nobody was giving me no answers besides him. He made me feel very comfortable. We laughed about a couple things. And, like, I was trusting him. I didn't even know this man's name. Never even seen this man in my life. I closed it because me asking for another card was not going to help. And I knew what they were doing. So, I closed it. And before I let the middleman know, I didn't let Delusional or Mr. Delusion know. Delusional, she was blowing my phone up. Yeah, I was looking at it. Like, honestly, when she was calling me, I was looking at it. I did not care. She was blowing my phone up. She was like, hey, what's the password? Mr. Delusion, he was like, I'm dumb as for messing up his play. And since my man wanted to mess up his cheese, he got one on his head. Like, Boy, ain't nobody scared of you. Shut your little ass up. Nobody ain't care about no one he was talking about. And my man would definitely fold you up like a pretzel, bro. Stop playing with me. Stop playing with him. After that, I was ignoring them. I told the middleman, he was the only one I told to. I said they closed it. But I apologized for wasting your time, and I just went on my merry way. Because her man was mad, and like I said, y'all, Delusional will fall behind Mr. Delusion. It don't matter. It don't matter what it is. Like, she one of them girls that would change up on you for her man. Like, if her man say change up, she will do just that. Like, she one of them girls that would do anything to keep her man. Okay? Since that happened, y'all, I was kind of prepared to not talk to her no more. I was just gonna let it ride out and whatever the case may be. But yeah, it's Thursday. The same night that I ignored them and basically the stuff was closed and they found out and Mr. Delusion was mad because we messed up his cheese, which is not yours because you're taking it from somebody else. Girl, tell me why she texted me hours later after me not responding to her at all. She texted me and she was like, oh,
Junior got a bruise on his forehead. Did he fall at your house or something?
Y'all, it's Thursday. I had Junior Sunday. It's Thursday, and I had Junior Sunday. Like, you ain't have nothing to say in between the time. So, she added, oh, I forgot to ask you. Bitch, you don't forget something like that. You don't forget something like, if you a real parent, you're not gonna forget something like that. Like, and on top of that, it's in the middle of his forehead, it's on his face. It's very visible. How you forget something like that? You don't forget something like that. So that was strike one where you made a mistake. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, what bruise? Like, show me where it sat. You know when babies are small and short, when they like try to lift their leg higher than what they're actually tall enough to do, most of the time it is not a far fall. And a lot of times it could just be because the baby head is big as fuck. Like, y'all, toddlers have big heads. Like, my son done felt like that before when he was smaller. Like, toddlers have big ass heads. So it's like, girl, he fell because his head probably was like heavy. Like, and I'm just making this little video too because I don't got no time for nobody to be like, you talking shit about the baby. Like, bitch, it is a fact. Like, it is a fact. The baby's heads grow 12 centimeters. Like, within the first year, their hair grow quicker. So, yeah, look it up. And it's no shade. Like, my baby done did that before. Like, babies done fell because they head took over the rest of their body. They just followed their head. But I just really feel like it's because he tried to step up where he couldn't basically handle, and he kind of felt a little bit, and all he did was just tap his little forehead on the little floor, and he didn't cry. I checked him, he didn't cry, and also I checked his body, and he was perfectly fine. He just tapped it a little bit. It wasn't no far fall. It wasn't like he fell down the steps. It wasn't nothing like that. And plus, babies fall all the time. So I didn't tell her because ain't no bruise on him and he didn't cry. But being that it was a step, I didn't want him stepping on it. By the time I seen him, he already was in a motion of leaning forward, y'all. So if y'all hear snoring in the background, that's my son, y'all. He snores, so don't do too much. Not too much on him. Thank you. He was like, oh, you should have told me that when it happened. Why would you not tell me that? Because now he got a bruise in his forehead. And I was like, if that was the case, I also told her, like, girl, if that was the case, if you felt like he got a bruise in my house, why you just not asking me? You should have been asking me when it happened. And she was like, oh, like I said, what did she say? Because she said something slick. She's like, it's not like I'm asking a whole month later. I'm asking now, the fuck? Then I'm like, bitch, as a mother, you was not finna forget something like that. As a mother, you gonna confront whoever it is, sister, brother, mother, cousin, boyfriend, girlfriend. You gonna confront whoever it is that your baby was under, you gonna confront them. I don't care. Like, you're gonna confront them if it's really something on that baby, y'all. So We like going back and forth. She not making no sense talking about some. Oh, if I pushed your son on purpose, you would want somebody to tell you. For one, you're not gonna push my son because you would get dropped before you even put your hands out. Two, why would you do that on purpose? Why would you push my son on purpose if your son fell on accident? For one, that doesn't make any sense. So you could just go ahead and scratch that out. So he told me some of this whatever about my son and blah 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 blah, and I'm like, let me see the bruise. Show me the picture of the bruise, cause you steady saying that he has a bruise. Let me see, right? I had, before she was sending it to me, I asked her a couple times and she was not sending it to me, y'all. So when she sent it to me, ain't nothing on the baby, y'all. Very, very bright skin. This boy is very fair skin. He's like, he's not as bright as Zendaya, but he like a little tint darker than her. So that's how you know this baby is bright skin. I should be able to see it from the distance that she had the video in. You don't have to be up close to him because he's bright skin. Ain't nothing on the baby. I was like, I don't see it. Get closer. Did I get another video? No. Did I get another picture? No, because it ain't no bruise on the baby. He did not get it from my house. She was like, oh, I forgot what I was like. She was like, oh, you been flake moving, da 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 da. And I'm like, I ain't been flake moving. The only person that been flake moving is you because y'all mad because y'all ain't getting no money. It's just like, I could give two about the money, da 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 da. I watched your son out of the kindness of my heart. I'm holding y'all stuff out of the kindness of my heart. And you over here talking to me like this, trying to blame this on me, like, knowing damn well, your baby ain't bump his head. Your baby ain't get that bruise in my house. Yeah, y'all, it was after that, I was like, you know what? Since you keep pressing the issue, I'm not even worrying about you. Like I said, we ain't gotta have this conversation, but since it's on the baby's behalf and you wanna lie so bad, I'ma just apologize on the baby's behalf. But other than that, girl, I'm not apologizing to you because you're lying. So after that, girl, we just cut the conversation short. I stopped. I wasn't talking to her, right? Next day comes. Yeah, my baby birthday party going on. I ain't text her all day itself for like around like 4:00 p.m. And I was like, hey, could you come get your stuff? Because I just feel like, girl, you did all this and you just lie like that. It was so easy for you to lie like that. Come get y'all stuff. And it wasn't no funny stuff, wasn't no nothing like that. Like, I just really asked her to come get her stuff. She was like, oh, I'm busy tonight. I'll come and get it in the morning after I made room in the car. I really could have just told you to come get your shit now, but I was like, you know what, great, fine, great, get it tomorrow. I really could have just told you to come get it now, but I'm still being nice to you, though. I'm still being nice. So fast forward next day. So it's 2:00 in the afternoon. You had all morning and early afternoon. Ain't texted me not one time, said she was on her way. I woke up late that day. Ain't texted me not one time. Sent her a question mark. Yo, the audacity. This girl said, don't text my phone. Text my sister. She has the card. Like, you've been too slick for too long. So I said, get a new number. Just won't get a new number. And she was like, pay for it. I'm like, ask your nigga for it. Ask that nigga you just love so much to pay for it. Ask him to pay for it. Girl, she said, ask your baby daddy to buy you a new phone. Bitch, I need a new phone, but ain't nobody ever complained to you about needing no new phone, baby. Yeah, girl, yeah, phone still works just as good. But she said, get a new phone. I don't know what I said to this girl, but she had the audacity to say, I don't know what she said, y'all. The only part, I only read the top half, y'all. This girl said she was gonna slap me, y'all. That's all I read. That's all I needed. I've been too nice for too long to your raggedy ass. You gonna slap me? V. Y'all, after I saw that, bitch, I'm on go. I was on go. I said, bitch, come do it. Come do it. Bitch, come do it.
My people keep playing with me like I really like. You feel me? Like, alright.
Like, you slap me? I had my hand out helping you? Girl, we going back and forth, right? Why she say where your baby daddy at? Why you worrying about where my man at? Don't worry about him. This how you know she young and childish. She like, oh, my baby, while I beat you the fuck up, my baby daddy gonna beat yours the fuck up. What's up? Who says stuff like that? Like, for one, listen, why are you including him? I said you need extra people. You need him to boost your ego. Because you said you was gonna slap me. You threatened me. Like, you threatened me. So do you need him to come boost your little ego so you can feel good about fighting? So it could pump you up so you could believe that you gonna beat me for real? Is that what you need? She like, oh, ain't no extra people, boo. It's just me and him. Where he at? And if he not there, then stop wasting my time. I'm not coming over there. I'm invited you to come do what you said you wanted to do. Ain't none of these niggas anything to do with it. If you want to come slap me, baby, come slap me. I'm inviting you to do it. I texted her sister. I was like, this ain't got, listen, Sadie, this ain't got nothing to do with you, but could you please come get y'all stuff ASAP? Like, please come get y'all stuff, y'all. So in the middle of me going back and forth with her, and me calling her P-U-S-S-Y, getting under that little skin, her sister told me to block her, but I ain't block her just yet because I knew she was gonna say something else. After I said we don't need them ninjas, you could come do what you said you wanted to do to me right now. Come do it right now. She said, oh, it's not worth hitting you. I bet. Bitch, I bet. I bet it's not worth hitting me. I'm not worth hitting you. Okay. Yeah, I bet. 20 minutes ago by her sister get here. I'm helping her sister. Her sister don't even know what's going on. I'm telling her what's going on. She's like, oh my God. I'm telling her the tea, y'all. This girl favorite word is suck my, fill out the blank. Suck my, ha ha ha. I don't do the back and forth. You've been the only one sending me paragraphs back and forth. And I've been inviting you to come slap me like you said you wanted to come slap me. You the one that's been typing me stories and paragraphs telling me how you feel. But you don't do all that typing. I said, like I said, if you not finna come slap me like you said you was, bitch, shut up. Tell y'all that got up under that whole skin. It got up under her skin, y'all. Because she was blowing her sister up. Why are you talking to her? Da 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 da. Why are you still at her house? You're not my sister no more. Getting the tea from her sister. Her sister confirmed to me that the baby bumped his head like 2 days ago after being with her or being with him. And she told the baby that the baby bumped his head because the baby be doing that to himself when he's upset. I didn't need that confirmation, but your sister, like, let me know that, bitch, you're lying. You just needed something to fight with me about because that nigga ain't no money. I already knew that. My own sister saying that you don't even take care of your son like you supposed to. You don't even feed your baby like you supposed to. But it's about your son, but it's whatever about your son. Girl, what is you talking about? You don't even mother him like you're supposed to because you always out with that. And I don't need to be around you to see that because every time you smoking and drinking with this, that's when me and Sadie still talking. Why she messaged me on my Snapchat telling me something? I'm pulling up tonight when I get the car because ain't nothing pussy about me. Ain't nothing cat about me. I'm finna come do what I said. Like, I'm finna come do exactly what I said. Girl, no, you're not. So what I did, I put laughing faces because I know you're a joke, girl. You're lying. You're not coming over here. You're not that for real. You're blocked her. My crew. My friends was on go. My bitches was on go. My brother was on go by me. Like, stop playing with me. They'll be that video by me. I'm talking shit about me. I'll be there. You think I'll be there? I'll be beat you up. Like, please. My homies, they were on go. Everybody was on go by me. Bro, when I tell you I had people on standby, to get him and her, yeah, me and you, yeah. If he was an issue, got somebody for you too. You took a lot of L's. You definitely took a lot of L's.
I ain't gonna lie to you. Like, you definitely just got like, damn, bitch, I can't even speak. You definitely took a lot of L's. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you. Like, you definitely took a lot of L's. You lost a bomb ass friend. Bitch, I'm a cool ass person. Like, one thing about me, I'm a good friend. Stop playing with me. You took a lot of L's. You got left here We got left here, y'all. She got left here. We got left here. Your sister done left you down here with this dude that you just love so much. I don't know if you still have your job, because from what I heard, you was calling out for him. You supposed to be with your with child, but you over here using and abusing. But like, I mean, you definitely took a lot of L's, but I ain't gonna, you know what, it'll get better.
The status coming from ain't nothing about me. Yes, it is. Ain't nothing about me. I'm not no Florida. I'm not no from where she from.
But yeah, I forgot to add this part in. But like, basically, she was trying to make herself seem the victim. She to their mom or whatever. Basically acting as if she's the victim and everything. But the sister told their mom everything that happened, bit about everything she was involved in, about how she would use gas money that was supposed to be for their car, but she using it for the dude, but the dude ain't got no car, and using their food stamps to buy him candy, like, instead of getting food for them. Like, this girl was just ridiculous, and their mom basically told the sister to take the kids and go back up home. Like, that it was ridiculous, y'all.
I'm just me. Hashtag management. Girl, you thought that that's not, you were not cute. But whatever. Then she had another one, y'all. Tell me some, she not nobody do, girl. You're definitely a do lie. You're a liar. Watch that man kids. You don't watch this man clothes. You don't get, like, you done did so much for this man. You go to this man events knowing y'all. Yeah, y'all. It's been a few days since. And I ain't hear nothing since. And yeah, that's why I'm making a story time right now. Because, girl, like, what's up with you? Like, girl, I done gave this girl my wig, y'all. That wig y'all see in that last video, I wore it once. Gave that girl my wig. Probably wearing right now. She probably don't wearing it right now.
Like, I done gave this girl my wig. I let her borrow it for one thing. Girl, I never gave it back. I used to ask for it. This girl, like, you'll get it when you get it. Girl, stealing. I let this girl wear some of my clothes, like, to go to sleep in. Girl, I ain't never got those back. I was asking about those. Girl, like, just taking a whole bunch of stuff. But I guess you can have it now, because we ain't friends no more. I guess you can have it. You can have it. I don't really want it. I could get that stuff again. But, like, yeah, before anybody, like, before, if she see this video, if y'all see this video, whoever see this video, don't be trying to do too much, because it's a story. I can tell a story. It's my content. I'm telling my truth. And let's just keep it pushing. Don't nobody know it's you. So, yeah, keep it pushing.
I hope y'all like the video. Make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe. To the new people, hey y'all, if y'all like this video, make sure y'all like it, make sure y'all comment, and let me know what y'all think, and yeah, we just gonna head and end the video off here. I love y'all, bye.